Ex-Premier League star DJ Campbell is one of six people questioned by police in connection with allegations of fixing in football matches. Mr. Campbell, who now plays for Championship side Blackburn, was one of six people arrested on Sunday. That came after ex-Portsmouth player Sam Sodd told an undercover Sun on Sunday reporter he could arrange yellow and red cards in exchange for cash. Five people were bailed on Sunday and sixth person was bailed on Monday. Portsmouth Football Club said it was shocked and saddened by the claims. Mr. Campbell, 32, whose full name is Dudley Jr. Campbell, played in the Premier League for Birmingham, Blackpool and QPR. Blackburn Rovers FC said in a statement, following reports in today's national media, Blackburn Rovers can confirm that striker DJ Campbell has been arrested. The club will be making no further comment on what is now an ongoing legal matter. The BBC has learned that discussions are ongoing between Blackburn Rovers, their lawyers and representatives of Mr. Campbell over his future at the club. It is thought there is no timescale on the talks between the club and Mr. Campbell. Blackburn have a home game against Millwall on Saturday. Red card. Police have not named the other five people arrested. On Monday, The Sun reported that Tranmere Rovers defender Ian Goodison, 41, was among the six arrested. The League One club said in a statement it was aware of reports in today's media regarding Ian Goodison but had no further comment at this time. Mr. Sodd was secretly filmed by The Sun on Sunday describing how he had punched an opponent in a League One game to get a red card in exchange for £70,000. He was sent off in the 50th minute of a League One match while playing for Portsmouth against Oldham Athletic on 23 February. His team were losing 1-0, which remained the final score. The Sun on Sunday also reported that an Oldham player, Christian Montano, apologised to Mr. Sodd after failing to get a yellow card in the first half of a match against Wolves on 22 October. And it said that Mr. Sodd's brother Akpo, a striker at Tranmere Rovers, had said he would be prepared to be paid to be booked. The allegations prompted the National Crime Agency to launch an inquiry. An active NCA investigation is now underway and we are working closely with the Football Association and the Gambling Commission, it said in a statement. Shocked and saddened. In a statement from Portsmouth Football Club, spokesman Colin Farmery said, "If these serious allegations are true, then we are extremely shocked and saddened by them, as much fixing of any type goes to the heart of the integrity of the game. Influencing a match used to be wholly more complex because it's 22 men, or 25 if you're including officials, you need to get to PFA chairman Clark Carlisle. The player in question no longer plays for the club and we have not been contacted by the authorities, but of course we would cooperate fully with any inquiry." Mr. Montano's club, Oldham Athletic, said it would be starting an immediate internal investigation. Tranmere said it was aware of Sunday newspaper allegations regarding Akpo Sodd but would make no further comment on the ongoing investigation. Former Professional Footballers Association, PFA, chairman Clark Carlisle said an increase in the number of betting markets in recent years had made it very easy to manipulate a single incident. Influencing a match used to be wholly more complex because it's 22 men, or 25 if you're including officials, you need to get to, he told BBC Radio 4's Today programme. But now something as simple as a booking, a red card, these can be manufactured incidents. I think the betting markets are something that we could have a look at as an industry. Educating players. We take the issue of integrity very seriously and will continue in our efforts to eradicate this evil from our game. Professional Footballers Association. Former FA chairman Mark Palios said one answer was to get into the dressing rooms and to make sure that the guys actually have the ability to safely whistleblow. The game should look to other industries that try to make it easy for the whistleblower, he told BBC Radio 4's Today programme. The Football League, meanwhile, said it took claims of criminal activity extremely seriously and would give police its full assistance. The Gambling Commission and Football Association said they were working with the NCA. A statement from the PFA said the allegations, if proven, demonstrated the real issue football faces in terms of corruption and showed how important it was to educate players of the risks. We take the issue of integrity very seriously and will continue in our efforts to eradicate this evil from our game. It added, in a separate NCAA investigation into an alleged international betting syndicate, two non-league footballers were last week charged with conspiracy to defraud. BBC Sports' Richard Conway said there had been an assumption for a long time that English football was immune to fixing.